are. Gentlemen, how wonderful to see you. Arthur, you remember this pair of boys we met in New York?
Come on, Jim.
Champagne is on dear old Arthur. He's rich as can be and feeling luckier than a turkey that survived Thanksgiving.
Hello, gentlemen.
Hello, dear boy. Come on, come on, let's head aboard. Drinks on Arthur. Champagne. Champagne all around.
I'm afraid we require all patrons to hand over their guns.
Good time. The tables await.
I'll go find myself a change of clothes.
Okay.
You seem unsure.
Robbing a heavily armed riverboat without a gun tends to bring out the self-doubt in me.
These people are virtually idiots. This is simple stuff. Now have a good time, but don't lose too much money or your wife is going to kill me.
Whatever you say.
Are you playing tonight, sir? We have a chair here with your name on it, sir.
Good evening, gentlemen. Arthur Callahan. Sorry I'm late. I had some unfinished business at the bar.
Desmond Blythe.
Evening.
Not to worry. Welcome to the game, Mr. Callahan. Okay, gentlemen, let's play.
I hope you're a player. Been too many cowards at these tables recently. Nothing less dignified than a man afraid to lose a little money.
Look at this! Chips already stacked up, waiting for me. I like this joint already.
We aim to please, sir.
So, how are we all faring?
Some better than others.
If we all fared the same in life now, where would the fun be?
Quiet.
Wait, not Desmond Blythe, the hosiery king. I should have brought my other wallet.
Not my preferred title, but yes, you should have.
We'll see about that.
To hell with it.
Nah, I'm out. Think I'll wait for this seat to warm up a bit.
I thought as much. Maybe you should have another drink, Mr. Callahan.
Here we go, then.
Well, hello, my ladies.
Damn it.
Mr. Blythe wins with three queens.
Goodbye, gentlemen. I guess it's just you and me now, friend.
Yes, it is.
Time to see if you're really the man you seem to think you are.
Likewise, Mr. Blythe.
So, what business are you in, Mr. Callahan?
I'm an oil man, for my sins.
Funny, I haven't heard of you.
Oh, you will. You know, I thought about getting in a hosiery, but I just look better in a suit.
I would stick to oil, Mr. Callahan. I don't think you have a future on the stage.
You sound just like my wife.
Sorry to do this to you, but I have no choice. All in.
Call. Interesting. Hair cowgirl.
Ship!
I guess my luck held.
Is that you done?
Done?
Bust. Or, you got something else to play with.
Meaning?
Well, I heard there was some big boys on this boat. Maybe that's not you. No offense.
Sit your hillbilly ass down.
Why?
I got a watch.
Look at you.
An expensive one. Real fine. Swiss. A Reutlinger, no less. It's in the safe upstairs. It's worth more than you.
Okay. I trust you.
Now play.
As you wish.
So, you must know Leviticus Cornwall, big oil man like you.
Of course, we've crossed paths. I was fortunate enough to tour a little operation heads up in New Hanover.
Let's not waste any more time here. All in.
Don't worry, sir. Everyone is the author of his own good fortune.
Well, nothing ventured, nothing gained. Pair of kings.
Very good, but not good enough.
Shit. Uh-oh. Yes, you little beauty.
Hard lines, Mr. Blythe. Mr. Callahan wins with an ace-high diamond flush.
God damn you!
No offense.
None taken.
Well played, sir.
Unlucky, Desmond.
Now, forgive my lack of discretion, but, where might I find this watch?
It's upstairs. Shall we go and have a look?
Why not?
Gentlemen.
Please, cash these out for me.
I started last week.
Good. Sure. Well, perhaps you could escort us up to the office.
Yes, of course, sir.
Thank you.
Follow me, gentlemen.
Come with me, sir. You're having quite the night.
Yeah, so far.
I cannot believe someone gave a greaser a job.
We live in strange times.
Personally, I wouldn't trust one with a gun, but fear not. I've got my own little lawgiver right here.
Very good.
Next, we'll be hiring Negroes.
Yeah, I know.
I think you're going to like this watch, sir. I saw it earlier, and it really is a handsome piece. Foreign made, but you can't have everything.
Indeed.
Well, here we are. Just give me 1 second, sir.
Of course, take your time. Don't reach for that gun.
Take his gun, Arthur.
I guess you were right. Only an idiot would give a greaser a gun.
Idiot, huh?
Shit, let's hope no one heard that. Quick, clear the safe. Let's get out of here.
Can't believe that asshole had another gun.
The view in here is looking pretty good.
How much is there?
Must be a few thousand plus the watch.
Nice. Now let's get out of here. Come on. Let's go meet the others.
Sure.
I reckon we've only got a few minutes to get out of here.
If we're lucky.
Was that a gunshot?
It sounded like one. Come on.
And how exactly are we getting out of here?
I ain't too sure. This is what tends to happen when you leave Trelawney in charge of planning. Oh, garnish no meat. Probably involve us dressing up as dancing girls and can-canning off the side. Nice uniform, by the way.
Thanks. You give anyone a job these days. Anyway, we shouldn't give ourselves away till we know we need to. Maybe we could still blend into the crowd when it all goes crazy.
Which it surely will. To the bar, senor!
I hope you had fun, sir.
At the time of my life. You boys sure know how to put on a show.
That's wonderful. Ah, look, there's your friend.
My friend is not a no-good cheat, and I beg you to take back the insinuation.
There he is!
Now, don't be a sore loser, friend.
There's something I don't like about the pair of you.
There's plenty I don't like about you, but I have the good manners to keep my mouth shut.
There he is! Shoot that man! Come on, Roger! We gotta get out of here!
My gondola. We need to get out of here.
How do you suggest?
I don't know. This ain't my show. Silly me. I clean forgot to bring my gondola.
Never a dull moment.
Yeah, that's one way of putting it.
So, how much did we get?
A few thousand, I think. Pretty good.
Yes, indeed.
And this watch. Apparently it's worth a bunch. Swiss. A Reutlinger or something?
Nice watch. Yes, it's a Reutlinger, all right.
We'll give it back then. All right, come on, let's get out of here. Hey! Who the devil are you?
Far as you're concerned, I am the devil. Now get out of here.
This cad!
I said get out of here!
You damn French. I don't quite know why I did that.
Because barbarity is boring, no?
It kept me amused some years.
You must go, my friend, before the gendarmerie arrive.
Hey, you gonna do right by this feller's wife?
You have done right by her. The little bird is free. I am an artist, cowboy. I must do what I feel. Look, I have an exhibit at the gallery. You come, see what I mean.
You
Yeah. Okay. So, what do you need?
Wait there. I'm coming straight down. Arthur.
Hello, Mary.
You came.
Sure. Whenever you call for me, I've come.
Oh, Arthur.
What's wrong?
Daddy.
Your father? I'm a bigger fool than I even thought.
I'm begging you, Arthur. I know Daddy was not kind to you, but surely you cannot hate a man for the sin of loving his daughter and wanting better for her than
me?
Than the choices you make.
What choice did I have? Did I ever have?
Oh, I know. You had to live by your code. But your code is... Well, it's not right.
Has your way been right, Mary? With you? And Jamie joining a bunch of crazies? And hypocritical daddy with his drinking and whoring and gambling? Huh? Is that what a pure life has gotten you? Begging me for help?
Oh, Arthur. Be kind to me. Please.
Sorry.
I am... I should have asked someone else, but...
But I'm the best guy you know at frightening decent people.
It wasn't that I didn't love you, Arthur. You know that.
Mama.
Oh, Arthur. We were so very young. Think how different life could have been.
Yeah, I think about it. A lot. It all seems so long ago and far away now.
Will you help me try to save Daddy?
Come along, Dan. Where are we going? What's the old lovable patriarch been up to now?
Oh, Arthur. You know sarcasm is beneath you. He's been gambling and drinking and... other things.
Oh, the filthy rotter. Where can we find him?
He said he was going down to the Theodore Eckhart stables. Something about a horse. It's down by the water in the warehouse district near the train yard.
Come on, then.
Don't be a pompous ass, Arthur. It doesn't suit you.
Oh, should I leave that to Daddy?
Leave Daddy alone. He suffers enough.
Well, I suppose I can take some consolation in that.
Oh, Arthur. I should have ran away with you years ago.
Well, you wouldn't.
No, I didn't. But... Well... I don't know.
So what do you think he's up to?
I'm not sure. He keeps saying it's a disgrace a man of his standing has to ride around on some old nag.
Standing? He's usually falling down.
Arthur. He wasn't always this way. But...
Hello, sir?
It has got worse. He's drinking and gambling more than ever. Pawning things off left and right. Mixing with bad people. I'm just scared for him.
Don't worry too much. Whatever it is, we'll work it out.
This is the place. Let me go in and see what kind of a state he's in.
Sure. I'll wait here. Good luck. Scream if you need any help.
Very funny.
You can't stand there.
What, in the street?
Yes, in the street.
Is it your street?
Just get out of here.
Why?
I said, just get out of here.
Listen, partner. I'm waiting on a lady. the fine lady. Let's just go on inside. If I wasn't waiting on this lady, you'd be dead already. But if you continue to irritate me, I'll kill you. And make my apologies to the lady, it's your call.
Oh, I didn't mean nothing.
You've never been so demeaned in my life.
Apology accepted. Oh, wait, right there.
I have half a mind to kill you myself.
Daddy.
No.
Oh, Daddy, please, come home. You're tired, Daddy, tired and
unwell. I have
no
such thing. You get away from me. You head home. I insist upon it. Leave me be. Damn nuisance.
Excuse me, partner. Still as charming as ever, I see.
Oh, Arthur, he's up to no good. We better follow him.
Okay.
This way. He went around the corner.
See why he has such a high opinion of himself. We'll just follow the smell.
Arthur, come on. He just went between those crates. Come here, quick.
Mind where you go. Mind where you go.
Sorry?
Do you think he saw us?
I don't think so.
What did you say to me?
I didn't say a thing insulting.
I'll wipe that goddamn smirk clean off your face.
Ain't you a little old for brawling, mister?
Damn you!
He's heading across the road.
You know, this is kind of fun.
Shh, he'll hear you. You could have cleaned yourself up a bit.
I didn't realize I was here to impress anyone.
He just went left down that alleyway. What's he doing?
Let's go find out.
Wait, Arthur. Any closer and he'll spot us. What's he doing? What do you think he's doing?
Well, he's either waiting for a woman of dubious morals, or he's trying to sell something.
So, Ashton, you got the money?
Seems he's selling something.
Have you got the brooch, Mr. Gillis?
Yes. Here.
Here's the money.
That is beautiful.
It's a family heirloom.
That was mother's brooch.
Not any longer, Mr. Gillis. Enjoy the money. And should you need any more, I can offer you a loan at a very reasonable rate of interest.
No, thank you. I've heard what happens to folks who take loans from you.
It's not even his to sell.
It's just a brooch. At least he didn't get himself killed.
You don't understand. Mother left it to me. You sold my mother's brooch? How could you?
You!
That's theft!
Oh, speaking of thieves, I see you found your outlaw again.
Hello, sir. Have you been well?
Daddy, how could you?
Mary, wait here. I'll go get the brooch.
Don't hurt anyone, Arthur.
He'll probably kill someone. Oh, would you like that?
Hold her right there! God damn it! Okay.
You got no damn backbone!
Hey!
that coach! Get back here! You hear me? Stop the damn coach! God damn it! You stop right now!
Leave me alone. Leave me alone. It's just a brooch.
I want that brooch. It wasn't Gillis's to sell.
I bought it fair and square.
How much do you want for it?
I guess I could give it to you for $100.
$100? What do you take me for?
Okay, okay. I'm a reasonable man. Let's say 50.
Not good enough, Ashton.
Okay, Jesus! $25, that's my final offer.
Yep. Where's your father?
I don't know.
You want me to go find him again?
Not really.
Well, let's take a walk. I'll take you to the trolley.
Thank you.
Yeah, got you your brooch back.
I won't ask.
Probably best not.